I'm Vanessa, and I'm Brazilian. I participate in Occupy Wall Street since before September 17. Okay, so yesterday was our 6 month anniversary, March 17th, and that was a big full day of celebration. There were marches and activities in Zuccotti Park. People were drawing with chalk in Zuccotti, but I was not there because I was attending the Left Forum during the afternoon at Pace University. So it was around 7 p.m. I was at Pace University and people came from Zuccotti into the front of the university, chanting out of the forum into the streets. It was very spontaneous, but that was not something that anybody planned before. And a lot of people got out of the forum and went with the march to Zuccotti, and I went together. So the march was really, really energetic. We were full of enthusiasm, very inspired, coming from the forum. We took the streets. We stopped the traffic, and the energy was great. And that's when we were arriving in Broadway, the police surrounded the march and forced it into the sidewalk. And in that moment, I saw two friends of mine getting arrested already. And so in Zuccotti, we were like around 500 people. And the plan was to start an occupation there again. It was something that came up during the afternoon. People were saying, no, let's occupy here tonight. That's our right. We can do that. Every 17th is our anniversary, right? And we always have actions on our anniversary. So I knew something was going to happen, but I didn't know, nobody actually knew that we were going to have this 24-hour attempt of occupation, which was something that came up. It was a big GA with a lot of people. We were, yeah, around 500 people. And then the Plus Brigades started doing their amazing work with everybody in the park. They do what they call art defense. The energy was really, really amazing. Everybody was really, really happy. Yeah, and then we also started setting a kind of a tent in the center of the park, which was taken by the police like 1 hour after we set the tent. And a Celtic band came playing Irish music. Everybody went there to dance with them, but the police came and arrested two of them and stopped the band from playing in St. Patrick's Day. It was around 11:30 in the night. The police said we had to leave the park. We said we had the right to be there. The police first came in the center of the park, but we surrounded the police and they left. But it was about 10 minutes later, they came back again, and then they came with a huge number. I would say more than 500. I mean, since the beginning, they were surrounding the park already in a really, really large number that I haven't seen since, you know, the day we were evicted in November. We prepared to resist. We had our orange mesh, which is what the NYPD uses a lot. Now we have our own. So we surround the park with our own orange mesh. But then the cops came and took the mesh and started pushing everybody out of the park. Some people got arrested right away there. Some people sat down in the center of the park to resist. Then they arrested these people who were sitting down. We decided to march to Union Square. Yeah, the cops were trying to separate our march, and then we were negotiating. They were like all the time telling us to quit or to get arrested. And through the march, where we were going to Union Square, the police started arresting really violently. They smashed a guy's face head into a window. Yeah, and the other guy, they dropped him on the floor. The police stepped in his face, broke his jaw, and broke his thumb. Sean Carrier. He was kept in the bus. They used a city bus to take the arrestees. He could still tweet because he had his cell phone with him. That's why I know that he had his jaw broken. And he said that from the bus, he was not the guy who had his head smashed, was bleeding and was still in the bus too. And they are still detained. We are now with a jail support group in front of the courthouse, waiting for them to get out. Five of them went to the hospital. Five of them were hospitalized. And tonight, so it's the plan is to converge at the Red Cube in front of Zuccotti Park to have a demonstration tonight about this brutality from the NYPD. But a lot of people who we have get used to see every day when we were in the park, they came out again yesterday. And it was great. It was really great to see all those people back again. We are using the Occupy term for broader, right? Than just, you know, having an encampment at some place. And the term Occupy is also like something that's becoming an idea of like occupy your mind, or you occupy yourself. The idea of, let's say, you are the one who have ownership's not the word, but let's say ownership of your own self. And also deoccupy for some situations. Deoccupy Tibet, or occupy for deoccupy Tibet. Or so there is a lot of playing with this word. But the idea of occupy for me is pretty much have consciousness that something is yours because you have the right. Like the park is yours, the park is ours, because we have the right. And my body is mine because it's my right. Yeah, so that's the idea. The idea of a revolution that we are talking about right now with the Occupy movement is something that become like is an exercise of first discovering how we have to relate to each other and, you know, how we relate to ourselves. But so in this sense of learning like how to live in community and learning how to care for each other and learning how to look around you and see what is important. And I think yesterday was, I mean, I could see like the emergence of the people to bring the Occupy movement in another level and talk and like spread and send a message to the world that we are alive and that we are like ready for something huge. And at the same time, how we communicate to each other and like we create this moment yesterday that was spontaneous. And that everybody was helping each other a lot, that we have this huge solidarity among ourselves. That's what we are building, and that's what's gonna be. It's being already the change that I am seeing, which is how we're learning how to be solidary. And yesterday, I think, was a big demonstration of that. We know that we have each other, and that's the way to go. We are not getting any weaker or afraid because of this. On the contrary, we are only bigger after these events.